Hey guys, welcome back to the Watch With Us channel. And in for the review this week, we have two watches from the Microbrand SYE. Now SYE stands for Start Your Engines, and it's a Microbrand that is based in Paris, France. And the two models that they currently have available are the SYE Start Your Engines Automatic 24, and the SYE Motion Chronograph. Now, this is their current packaging for their watches. In here, you'll get a strap and the pièce de résistance, the watch itself. Here, we have, as I stated, their Motion Chronograph in their black dial. All their current models either come in this black brushed dial or in this silver brushed dial you see here. Now, starting off with the black dial, let me just clean that up a bit. With the black dial here, your layout is a 60-minute counter here at 9 o'clock. You have a 24-hour display at 3, which has a subtle difference in terms of just the color. The 12 to 24 part is slightly darker than the 24 to 12 part, which distinguishes your day and night. You get the date here at 6 o'clock. Once again, the counter at 9. A blued chronograph hand. Same thing with the chronograph minute counter. Inside, you have a Seiko V64 Meca-Quartz movement. So when I click here, you get that nice smooth sweep of the chronograph hand. Stop it, reset. Going to the back of the watch, you have the Start Your Engine, Motion, serial number. The watch comes with 5 atmosphere, so 50 meters of water resistance, stainless steel, sapphire crystal. Now, in terms of dimensions on these watches, both of the watches, in terms of dimensions, are similar. Only difference is, of course, is you have your chronograph pushers here compared to just one right here. Terms of just the crown. Now, size of these, you're talking about 40.5 millimeters. Now, that's from this edge to right here before you get to the crown. But in terms of the actual bezel, you're looking at a bezel that comes in at 37 millimeters. Thickness is 13.4 millimeters, and that includes the special part of this watch. That is the case back, which helps you with the integrated straps that you have. Now, this system on the watch is called the fastback system. And the way it works is, and I'm going to take this off on my wrist so you kind of see, is this piece along with this screw here keeps these strap in place. These straps are Jean Rousseau straps, also another strap maker and brand coming out of Paris. They taper down to about 18 millimeters, really nice quality. But the way the system works is you would take your strap, place the watch right here, place your strap here. If you guys see, best way to do this is actually open this up. Place your strap here, and then you would go ahead and place this over the straps. Once that's in, place your tightening screw there. And now what you can do is you can go ahead and tighten the screw. And I found to do this, it's always good to have just something under the watch crystal so that you can really tighten this up. And there you have it. And now you've used your fastback system and you've placed your straps on the watch. Now, in terms of pricing for these watches, actually, before we get to pricing, on the automatic version, let's dive into that dial. We get a 24-hour counter right there at 9, blued hands, also accompanied here on your seconds hand. You have loom on the hour and minute hands, same as you do on the chronograph here. You have a minute track here on the rehaut. Date is located at 3. You have SYE right there underneath the 12 and 24 automatic at the 6. Inside you have a Miyota 8217 movement. Water resistance is the same at 50 meters. Straps are basically the same. And you have your signed buckle here, as well as your signed crown. Now, in terms of our positives and negatives with these watches, I'm going to go ahead and start off with the negatives. These watches are race inspired, so of course they have a sporty vibe. So I wish the watches had come with 100 meters of water resistance. I think that would have been great. So I know not everyone feels the same way when it comes to water resistance, but especially when you think that these actually don't come with screwed down crowns, they come with regular crowns. I would have loved to have seen 100 meters of water resistance on these, or at least a screwed down crown. Second thing is this fastback system. System is cool. There's no doubt about it. I like kind of where they were going with these. It is a cool little system to have on these in terms of changing the straps, but they don't necessarily make changing the straps easier. So it's one of those things, it's akin to individuals who like a manual transmission on their cars versus an automatic. That's kind of the vibe you get here. Doesn't necessarily make things easier, but there's definitely a cool factor when it comes to putting these straps on. In terms of positives, I'm going to go back to the straps. These straps are amazing quality. The straps are, of course, from John Russo, as I mentioned earlier. They're a really nice strap maker out of Paris, and they really do a good job of integrating the nice leather with integrated lugs. And it's something they do for a lot of watch brands, and they even do custom work for a lot of watch brands when it comes to creating straps for integrated designs. Another positive is definitely these dials. I think these dials are just really amazing. Really capture the light. The indices with all those facets do a great job of capturing the light. That subtle detail in terms of the 24-hour sub dial, a lot of nice contrast on the dial in terms of the blue, the white, the black, the silver. It just really works, and it really goes with that whole racing design kind of aesthetic. The watches also wear really comfortably on the wrist. Let me toss this on my 7.5 inch wrist so you guys see what I'm saying. This is how it looks with the automatic. I mean, it's basically a round design, so you're getting that 40.5 up down and that 40.5 left right, and the 37 millimeters actually makes it wear smaller than 40. So that's how it looks with the automatic, and here's how it looks with the chronograph. Kind of see, wears really well, and that amazing looking dial. Now, in terms of pricing, you're looking at the base price for these. Base price for the motion chronograph is $843. Currently, it's on sale for $645. Base price for the motion automatic 24 is $991. Currently, it's on sale for $793. And in terms of the straps, they have multiple options on the website, and those are on sale for $149, which is right in line with the Jean Rousseau quality and the Jean Rousseau straps. But overall, these are really interesting designs. It's an interesting take on chronograph, racing-inspired chronographs and racing-inspired automatics. I think if you're looking for just something interesting, these might be a good option for you out there. It is definitely a very competitive market in terms of racing-inspired chronographs and automatics under in that sub 1K zone. But what I like is you really aren't going to find a lot of things that look like this and that have that cool kind of system. But you also have to think about the price of admission when you're dealing with these watches. If you want to change out straps, you can't just toss on regular straps. You're going to have to go through the brand or even Jean Rousseau, and those straps are going to cost you $150 a pop. So you definitely have to think about that. But that completes it for my review, guys. Definitely take an opportunity. You have any comments, questions, drop them off in the comment section below. Going to be posting some more content on these on the Instagram page, so definitely follow us there. But I hope you guys enjoyed my review of the SYE Motion Automatic 24 and the SYE Motion Chronograph. I'll see you guys next week.